to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment. Please keep our servicemen and women in your thoughts and prayers as you go about your daily lives. And this week in particular, please keep the victims of the natural disaster, earthquake and tsunami in Japan in your thoughts and prayers as well. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us for our fifth committee meeting for the Senate Standing Committee on Local Governments. We have a rather complete agenda this morning. I want to start by thanking my colleague, Senator Little, for being here. Thank you very much for being here. A couple of good bills on today. We'll start to
The first bill is Senate Bill 205 by Senator Maziarz. It's an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to requiring events to veterans to be displayed on a community board. Specifically, this bill would authorize each county, city, town, village by local option to adopt by local law a resolution to provide a bulletin board for veterans organizations wish to post and display information for upcoming events. This bulletin board would be conspicuously displayed either at the location where the local legislative body meets or where municipal offices are located. Once again, this is by local option.
Right. There's no requirement. You said the word require, but there's no requirement.
Thank you.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Bill supported.
Senator, it's in the title. It's not in the structure.
It caught all this.
it's just in the title, which doesn't become part of the law.
It's not a popular word this year.
Yeah, that's correct. The next bill, Senator, is Senate Bill 579 by Senator Klein. This is an act to enact the Wireless Facility Siting Act to amend the general municipal law in relation to the placement, construction, and modification of wireless service facilities. Specifically, this bill would establish this act to provide for local regulation and permitting of cell towers.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I have some comments on this because, in this area from Long Island, I guess this originated in a Long Island situation. There are a lot of cell towers, and people really want to have more input and slow down the building of cell towers. In my area, we don't have a lot of coverage. This would really complicate the siting of cell towers. And the fact that it's statewide, it is my objection. I think it should be confined to the county that's having a problem with it, not a statewide bill, and therefore I would vote no.
Very well. I do note that it has been should it be reported, will be reported to Commerce, I think specifically for that reason, to allow for the other side of exactly what you're discussing. I do have certain questions and concerns with respect to the radius and the notice requirements and the global approach to it. On the other hand, I do note that it does apply to all properties, including those cell towers that are sited on state land, that sometimes local communities don't have the ability to comment on. So it does provide for a broader range of local input.
They should all have an Adirondack Park Agency.
Love to have thousands of open acres in my backyard, too.
Yeah, thank you.
Anyone else? Okay. Got motion. All in favor? Aye.
Ayes 5, noes 1. Senator, receive without recommendation.
Thank you.
This bill is reported to Commerce, as Senator Martin's indicated. The next bill is Senate Bill 1737 by Senator Grassanti. This is an act to amend Chapter 616 of the laws of 1992 relating to authorizing the conveyance of state land in the city of Buffalo. Specifically, this bill would allow the Women for Human Rights and Dignity Development Corporation, which is a charitable corporation which assists single mothers and formerly incarcerated women to convey property they no longer need, which was publicly conveyed to them in 1992. The Office of General Services has determined that it is surplus state land, which they do not need in the city of Buffalo, and is willing to waive their right of reverter in the event that there's legislative action.
Make a motion to approve.
All in favor?
Aye.
I-6.
Bill's reported.
Our next bill is Senate Bill 2374A by Senator Stuart Cousins. It's an act to authorize a municipality to issue serial bonds to finance certain payments over a period of 5 years. Specifically, this bill would authorize the process known as smoothing, whereby a municipality would be authorized by local option to issue bonds for a period of not more than 5 years in order to fund the cost of participation in the 2010 early retirement incentive.
Thank you very much.
All in favor?
Aye.
I-6.
Great bill. No. Thank you. It helps a lot.
Our next bill is Senate Bill 2778 by Senator Griffo, an act in relation to making certain findings and determinations with respect to bond anticipation notes issued by the Village of Norwood, which is in St. Lawrence County, and validates and legalizes such notes. This is very similar to the bill we had with Senator Ritchie a few weeks ago. Specifically, what this bill would do is correct an administrative error made by the village when they mistakenly exceeded their maximum bond authorization and mistakenly thereby failed to make required principal payments on bonds issued by the Department of Agriculture, the Federal Department of Agriculture, which were used in the financing of a capital improvement project for wastewater collection and treatment, and which legally was imputed to the village's bond limit. This bill would validate and legalize such notes and authorize the issuance of obligations of such bond anticipation notes, thereby bringing the village in accordance with the provisions of the local finance law.
Move bill.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
I-7.
Bill reported.
Our next bill is Senate Bill 2843 by Senator Carlucci. It's an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to authorizing cities, towns, villages, school districts, and boards of cooperative educational services and library districts to enter into cooperative agreements. Specifically, this bill would amend the general municipal law to authorize a city, town, village, school district, fire district, BOCES, or public library to pool with another municipality through the establishment of a central office for the provision of and in order to reduce the cost of providing the
Before we continue, I just wanted to recognize First Senator Stuart Cousins, who I didn't recognize a few moments ago when she did arrive at Senator O'Connor.
I see, Jack. She scared you.
You saw that?
No. I was going to commend him on really moving in that direction.
In the right direction. We'll have fruit next.
Yes. You see what happens. Everybody is afraid of the donuts.
It's incremental.
The fruit is good. You know, I had some bills in last year on this subject, and then I was told, you know, BOCES could do things with municipalities already. Could do that. I thought we needed legislation in order to do that.
The enabling statute for BOCES allows some of these things to be done. This allows other types of municipal, from local districts to school districts to fire districts to cities, towns, and villages to do it together.
You can't join together for health insurance. A lot of it has to do with experience ratings, community ratings, and all that, but they really don't even let towns join together to purchase their health insurance.
Well, maybe not through a BOCES, but
they don't. They do it through a private.
Yeah, I was about to say at least five of my towns have a health consortium for years ago. So.
Well, they can buy Empire too, they can buy the state insurance, right?
I guess it's in keeping with the efforts over the years to encourage consolidation, not only school districts, but also local governments, and to the extent that communities may not want to consolidate wholly, it does allow them the opportunity to consolidate some of their other administrative functions.
Right.
And hopefully, by consolidating them, advance our goal of savings. So I think.
Even for some small towns to, you know, join together in their efforts for payroll and.
Right, back office.
Back office operations.
But when I, and I did put it in the last year, but the fact is, I was told it could be done anyway, so.
Well, both.
They move the bills.
They can do it, it's just a matter of.
But I hear what you're saying, it brings in fire districts and water districts, sewer districts, you know.
And BOCES by its nature, and it's enabling legislation to agree with BOCES concept, allows for consolidation. Some of these other localities don't have that. There are limitations to what BOCES can do.
And BOCES provides insurance consortiums for a lot of the school districts, provide health insurance through BOCES. You know, they just group them more or less and get one rate.
And they have been successful.
Yes.
In that respect, and so to the extent that we can take that model and expand it somewhat to other groups, towns and villages and like.
No, it's a great bill, and I was just curious because I.
Well, I think they can do a lot, but I think it's just to try to state and encourage them, it must be, you know, some.
Particularly upstate, I did a lot of hearings upstate on BOCES when I chaired education. Man, they really need it up to our way. In our way, it's a nice thing, but it's not essential to our survival. But I was hearing it was essential to
BOCES.
Survival.
Well, BOCES is important, you know, they're still.
Someone like to move the bill?
Sorry, we just got a philosophical question here. We're not going to get them to consolidate. So how can we get them to share?
They'd rather share than consolidate when they're given the option.
Yeah.
Well, they won't consolidate.
Well, that's what I'm saying. They'd rather share than consolidate when they're given the option.
All in favor?
Aye.
I-7, Senator Ritchie with our committee.
Thank you.
A bill's report. The last bill we have on our agenda is Senate Bill 2897 by Senator DeFrancisco. It's an act to amend the general municipal law and the education law in relation to purchasing services through the Department of Education. Specifically, this bill would authorize village, town, or county to make purchases through the State Department of Education or any local school or BOCES district. This bill would further authorize the Commissioner of Education and any local school district or BOCES district to share procurement contracts for telecommunications and information technology services with any village, town, or county.
This is the bill that had been on a couple of weeks ago here. Spoke to Senator DeFrancisco and specifically with regard to the concerns of reimbursement. He said that the bill, and again, rereading the bill, just speaks to the opportunities for local communities to avail themselves of contracts that BOCES may have. And to the extent that BOCES provides either a service or a product that they can get more cheaply by going through their contract, that's what they're trying to provide.
I'm totally against this bill. And I think that what it does is help government compete with the private sector. In the BOCES program, we have telecommunications, particularly the NARA programs, regional IT programs that BOCES has. They're just growing. They come in and they offer a Cadillac program to the schools right now. Then the schools get a reimbursement, which makes it cheaper than what the local telecommunications companies have offered. And what the telecommunications locally offer is, you know, adequate services. And you know, we have several instances where, because of the reimbursement, they outbid the local telecommunications. We're also talking about this 20% for women and minority-owned businesses. one of the telecommunications companies I have is a women minority-owned business. They've already lost a lot of school districts because of this in the North Country. And if this opens up to local governments, they would lose those. And they're already reaching far beyond their district in order to get business, and they've already laid off people. So we're not trying to grow empires of government, I think, and that's what this does. So I'm against it, and I think that it, and I hope it doesn't go any further.
There's a reimbursement component when it comes to school districts, which makes them
unfair competition, but it also
unfairly competitive when it comes to school districts. But if you're dealing with villages and towns and the like, there is no reimbursement component, so it's a strict
number. No, but when you're a government entity, there's a lot of things that you don't have to do that the private sector does. The private sector is paying corporate taxes, they're paying property taxes on their office buildings. They are, it's just, and even with the component for the schools, these schools who got the $60,000 program for $19,000, even though the locals bid $20,000. They were underbid by BOCES because of the reimbursement. That's $41,000 of education money that didn't necessarily need to be used. It supported a government program rather than the lower cost, $20,000, which would have supported the local economy.
Trust me, I do understand. There's one thing about BOCES that has been reiterated, and coincidentally, I just had a discussion earlier this week with them. When you're dealing with a product, it's dollar to dollar. It's very simple. When you're dealing with services, one of the objections that BOCES has had for the costs that sometimes are associated with their services, precisely the fact that they have to pay a higher standard when it comes to employees, when it comes to certain expenses and benefits and the like, that many in the private sector don't have to. So they feel that, if anything, they're actually forced to pay even more for services than people in the private sector, thereby being undercut. Product to product, if somebody wants to buy a piece of equipment and they can do it through a BOCES contract because it's cheaper for the local community, I would think that that's what we want to do, provide the local community with the opportunity to purchase that piece of equipment more cheaply.
My school districts have come back after talking to them a little bit and said, you're right, that what we're getting is, a person on site, which the local provider doesn't provide, but they're there in the community. They might not be able to respond to their call within 20 minutes because they're not down the hall. But it's a catalog program, and several of them have said, in the BOCES itself, in my district, does not use NEREC. Here's the local. We're into a buy local program, I thought, to help the local economy, not help state government. Anyway.
Okay. Fair enough. Anyone else?
Well, our local is this humongous cable vision, so I don't have a lot of sympathy for them. I'd rather go with BOCES. So I'm yes on this.
Well, I had sponsored one that was a little bit less inclusive because mine was just for IT, and Betty, you didn't care for that one much.
Yeah.
So, but for the same reasons, and I respect those reasons. No. So anyway, I would guess.
So, all in favor?
Aye.
I-6, that was one.
All right, and that is referred to finance. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining me this morning.
I want to commend you for having breakfast for us.
Good luck in your budget.